They say baseball is America's pastime. But for Milwaukee resident Dennis Biddle, baseball was known by a different name.
We didn't have a baseball, so we called it stickball. We took a sock and stuffed it. That was the baseball. We cut out a neighbor's tree, little tree, and made a bat out of it.
Growing up in Magnolia, Arkansas, Dennis excelled at all sports. At 17 years old, he was ready to accept a scholarship to play football at Grambling until fate and a scout from Chicago intervened.
Chicago American Giants asked me if I would like to try out for the team. And I said, yeah. He said, be in Chicago Tuesday morning, Washington Park, Diamond number 3. Still rings in my ears.
Shortly after, Dennis became the youngest pitcher to take the mound in the Negro Leagues.
I learned about life riding that bus every day with those old living players, those players from the Negro League. Not only did I learn about life, I learned about what happened in the league that I was now part of way before I was born.
History that included those who swung for the fences while Jackie Robinson broke the color barrier in 1947, a time James Beckham was a part of.
We weren't playing for the money. We only played on the weekend because everybody had to work. You had to stand and watch the game on foot because they didn't have, like, to go to the ball stadium now, go in the bleacher, you know, and you sit. That couldn't happen. But the crowd used to be there, and they used to come in and look forward to seeing a good game, and that's what it was.
In 2020, Major League Baseball designated the Negro Leagues as Major League, acknowledging nearly 3,400 athletes.
And we had a young guy on our team, his favorite Satch, and we called him Little Satch. When he had 2 outs and 2 strikes on the batter, he used to call, when he released the pitcher, he called strike 3 and threw walking to the dugout.
It's a gesture James wishes some of his fellow teammates were still around to see.
It would have been a lot if they could have been into the history book a long time ago. If things had been different back then like it is now, you would have seen a lot of great ball players, black ball players into the league. In fact, I grew up with a bunch of them.
Back in 1996, Dennis founded yesterday's Negro League Baseball Foundation, honoring and fighting for rights players deserved.
We had no representation. People were using our name, our likeness. They were making millions and millions of dollars. None of that money was going to those old men who played and had nothing. And this disturbed me. This is why we organized.
With their eyes on the future, the foundation is making strides to put baseball back in black communities.
We're going to start training four-year-olds and start training them. So by the time they get to Little League, they would have know about the game, and the interest will be there. So it'll take 10 to 15 years, but it's going to come back eventually, I hope.
Hoping to one day help James, who has been developing baseball in Milwaukee since 1966, accomplish a personal dream.
The thing that we've been trying to do is win the Little League World Series. That's one of the goals we're still fighting on. And I'm hoping one day that we can do it.
Dennis, James, and the remaining living members of the Negro Leagues may not be as well known as Jackie, Ernie Banks, or the late Hank Aaron, but they are perhaps more important to the game's future because they are still swinging for the fences. Delaney Bry, TMJ4 News.